We're on the line with Sanaz. Sanaz, why don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I'm Sanaz and I'm from Iran, but I live in Sweden and I'm studying here my master degree.
What are you studying?
I'm studying environmental engineering.
That's an important profession.
Yeah,
Absolutely.
especially here in Sweden. They really care about the environment.
Is that right? So, yes, that seems to be a global trend towards that type of environmental consciousness. So, what is your goal? What would you like to do once you graduate?
I really want to study my PhD in the same major, and I want to study here, maybe in Sweden or another Scandinavian countries.
What got you interested in this topic of environmental law
Or
and
environmental
policy
engineering. All right.
engineering?
My bachelor was the same topic. It was natural science, and I really care about the environment because, as you know, about the climate change and biodiversity and stuff like that, the pollutions, it's the main concern of the countries. That's why it makes me more interested, because I think that there will be more jobs in these topics. So that's why I choose this topic.
Well, is there a particular area of specialty that attracts you that you're interested in within environmental engineering?
Especially I think that the environment is somehow very broad subject, and the thing is that I want to go through in environmental assessment part. For example, there are some tools and methods that are using to just consider that if a product is environmentally friendly or not. For example, life cycle assessment, they will study the product from being produced until the end of the product. They just go and study all parts from the production, construction, and every details, and then they will change a little bit if it's somehow not good for environment.
Can you give us an example of the kinds of products?
For example, for chair, they give materials from China. It's not that friendly because it needs a lot of transportation, and they
Sure.
count every details of that. For example, how many oils or how many stuff does it need, or how many screws, and they just change everything. For example, they want to make less screw or less attachment, just to make it more environmentally friendly. And
So,
it's
in other words, they will examine how a chair is manufactured, how it is made, and then once it's made, how it is transported to where it's going to be sold.
yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Yeah, they also talk even about like food miles or maybe food kilometers, of how far something may be organic and very healthy, but it travels across a country to get to you, and that
Exactly.
produces a lot of
Well,
pollution and
I mean, in America, we have this slow food movement. You've heard of fast food, like burgers and fast food restaurants. Well, now there's this trend to buying local, buying your food from the local market, from the local farmers, and being environmentally friendly in that way, so the food is not traveling as far, it's fresher, so it's healthier for you. And also more manufacturing within America, not only for jobs,
That's
but
rare.
also it seems to speak to what you're saying. It's more environmentally friendly to do it that way.
Yeah, that's right.
In Iran, we hear, of course, that Tehran, in particular, the capital, is very polluted. Is this something that you would like to go back to the country and help?
Yeah, it's worth trying, but if there will be a position, or if they use the standards very well and they consider everything, yeah, why not? It will be good.
Yeah, pollution's a problem in a lot of big cities with a lot of traffic and so forth. But how did you get interested in this? I mean, were you interested in this in high school or growing up?
In high school.
But what got you interested in studying environments? Was it something?
Actually, at first, I was thinking about job, but then when I, because it was a new field, in especially in Iran, because I studied my bachelor in Iran, and it was a very new field, and it makes me very interested in these courses, and then little by little, I really enjoyed, and that's why I choose to come and do my master's in the same field.
So you started off, it sounds like she started off just some as a way of making money, but once you got to know about it, now your heart is really into it.
Yeah.
Now tell us a little bit about your experience learning English. How did you learn English, and what advice do you have for other English learners?
Learning English in Iran is somehow different because in Iran we used to study by ourselves, and in schools we don't learn a lot of English, so we should study by our interest and we should practice by our own. And but here the thing that made me surprised here was here everyone can speak English very fluently, and even elders can speak very well English. And they find that you are a foreigner, they easily switch to English.
How's your Swedish?
My Swedish is not good. That's why, because they speak English very well.
They're practicing their English on you.
but the thing is that I think it is very rude that I say that I am studying 2 years my master here and I don't know any Swedish. I went to Swedish classes, but it's very hard, you know. Learning a new language needs a lot of time and effort and practice. And I have my courses in university, and they are in my second language too. So I try to learn and improve my English rather than studying Swedish.
We were talking with an Iranian gentleman before, Arash, and he was saying because he learned English in childhood, that it's a little easier for him now as an adult to learn English more, and he's trying to learn Greek, which he said was very difficult.
He's living in Greece right now, and so he's over in Greece trying to learn Greek, and you're here in Sweden trying a little bit to learn Swedish.
It's a point that, you know, Swedish, because even here you can find a job as an international in English too, but it's better to know Swedish to get job easier. That's why Swedish is important for me too. But and a lot of English words is using in Swedish, so it's not that hard to learn Swedish.
Well, great. Well, Sanaz, thank you so much for joining us, and good luck in your studies, and hope you'll keep in touch and let us know what where you go in your chosen field now. So. Take care, and nice talking to you.
Khodafez.
Yeah, nice to meet you and talk to you.
Khodafez.
Khodafez.